देख बिना ब्रेक
डाउनलोड तक ऐप।
तरीके से आपका 2019 गया था, सबकी नज़र मनु पे है और ओलंपिक ईयर होने के नाते एक अलग एनर्जी, एक अलग मोटिवेशन होगा।
बिल्कुल सर, ओलंपिक ईयर है तो मैं और भी ज़्यादा ट्रेनिंग पे फोकस कर रही हूँ और काफ़ी ज़्यादा एक्साइटमेंट भी है और नर्वसनेस भी है बहुत ज़्यादा कि ओलंपिक्स है अभी और ओलंपिक्स में परफॉर्मेंस के बारे में भी बहुत ज़्यादा सोचना पड़ता है। तो आई थिंक इट्स गोना बी गुड।
And then one more thing, I mean, it's a dream of each and every athlete to like represent our country in as a sporting event like Olympics. Do you think, I mean, you're going for the first time, it's a big thing for you. How exactly do you, I mean, exactly you are dealing with everything? I mean, your studies, your training sessions, pressure, everything is there, right?
When I started shooting, I never thought that I'll be going, I'll be reaching this, like this higher stage and I'll be, you know, going to Olympics, of course. But now, step by step, I rose up and I did so well. And now also I have to manage between studies also and practice also, meditating as well, training my mind also, like mental training, physical training, everything. So, now it's more like my lifestyle, training every day and everything, like training for different tournaments. It's like my lifestyle now. Earlier it was just a hobby, I like opted it, but now it's like my lifestyle. I can't live without shooting, and so every day it's like I have to shoot, I will shoot, and it's what I love.
Right. And one more thing, I mean, shooting is one of the events where medalex hopes are very, very high. I mean, because we have certain shooters and you, some other shooters. So how exactly the team is getting up? I mean, you have 2-3 events, 10 meter and 25 meter, which is your expertise. So how exactly you are dealing? And do you feel that there are some kind of things that needs to be taken care from here till Olympics?
I would say extremely good shooters are doing extremely good. It's been like last 2-3 years now, it's like on the peak. So I think now also we'll see a good show in Olympics. I also hope so. And about 25 meters and 10 meters, I give importance to, like, equal importance to both of these events, because I know that, you know, both of these medals same. And I train more for 10 meters because of 10 meters I improve my 25 meters also. It's something technical, so I focus on technical things more, so that improves my 25 meters also.
Right. And Manu, I mean, shooting here, practicing here in Kanuji shooting range, and when you go outside and when you train there, when there is a competition, what are the differences that you feel that our shooting range should have for an athlete?
I think our shooting range is also one of the best shooting ranges ever I have ever visited or ever trained at. But I think the targets, because we see a lot of lanes which are not in good condition or which are not working. So it's like just a technical thing that the lanes need to be like worked on. Or because like there are a lot of shooters who are not really good in shooting, but and they hit the light or the, you know, the frame of the shooting target, so that because of that only it happens. But otherwise I think it's one of the best ranges ever I've trained on,
and
I'm happy with the coaching also and with the facility also.
Right. Manu, we have seen you when you were there in the World Cup, when you won the gold medal, after the Commonwealth Games medal, then Asian Games, good performance in the Nationals. Are you satisfied? I mean, are you hungry? I mean, to better and bring laurels for the country, and one dream which exactly that you're dreaming for is Olympics. So, any comment on that?
In my case, I think even if I win the Olympic gold, I'll be still hungry, because till the time I'm shooting, till the time I'm in any sport, I'll try my best so that my country feels proud of me, so that my country, you know, I can make my country proud. I can, you know, take my country higher. So I think that's what make me feel hungrier every time.
Last couple of questions. I will not take much of your time. 2016 Rio Olympics, 2 medals, both women.
Both?
Women's. Okay. Women's. PB Sindhu and Sakshi Malik.
Sakshi Malik.
Do you think that women's participation and women's empowerment in sports is also very important?
Definitely, I think so. Because, you know, it's not, society grows up with both of them. Like, female and male are both equally important because, you know, male can't dominate all the time, or maybe it can't take the society higher. It always requires all the... you know, all the parts of the society to be developed and to be grown up. So I think equal, you know, when we keep male and female both equal, na, it takes the society higher. It develops something positive in the environment, and everything is, you know, you'll see people are more mature, and everything's get you know, simpler. So I think definitely female empowerment, women empowerment. Leads to success
in sports,
also in society, also in every aspect of life.
One final question to you, Manu, and this is about awards and rewards. You have done so well in the last couple of years. What exactly do you feel that you should be given?
I don't know. It's up to government and the federation, whatever they suggest me.
Given to you last time because of your performance was there, but NRI was. I mean, there was no recommendation from NRAI. Do you think that, I mean...
I actually don't know what to say about this, but yes, the federation and the government only see that, like, do I, you know, even stand for, like, I have, even, do I have in, like, I don't know. I've tried my best. I've tried my best, and it's up to them what they feel. Like, if they feel to, like, giving it or, like, you know, awarding me with some national awards, or so it's up to them. I try my best. It's like always I try my best. I don't know. Now it's their you know, job. So I don't think about that so much. It's like you do your best, and whatever comes to you, just accept it.